What's happening, y'all? It's your boy DC Curry coming to you live from the ATL, from the new improved Uptown Comedy Corner. You listening to DisRace, where our motto has always been no hate, but no fear. You got to know when to hold them, know when to fold them, know when to walk away.
And we never run.
We never do running. Respect everybody.
Fear none.
And fear nobody. Respect all. And fear none. I got my main man, the chaplain, the Mohican minister. Ladies and gentlemen, show your love for Mr. Brian Harper, the reverend, the right reverend.
That's right.
As opposed to the wrong reverend.
Exactly. You know what it is. Always winning, never losing.
Always winning, never losing, and never gambling.
Yeah. So I'm like the South Carolina Gamecocks, man. Female, you know, undefeated.
And you wouldn't bet on them.
I told you, I do not gamble, but hey, if I was a gambler, I would have bet on it.
How do you think the Lord feel about this is money you can make and tithe out of it, but your scared ass won't bet?
He don't want me to come obsessed with it. He knows me. I'm too competitive.
You obsessing?
I would get obsessed with it on winning and losing.
Obsessive too like that of women and stuff?
Not at all.
Latch on and go crazy?
Nah.
Nah,
I don't do that. I'm not possessive. You can gasp.
Can I call a witness up to the...
Sure.
Sure. I got my main man, Tim Black.
Tim Black in the building. How y'all doing? Is my mic on? How's it going?
Is my mic on? He sound like Peter ain't getting no amen. Yeah, your mic on. Don't nobody know who the hell you are. He ain't hear no hand clap at me. I'm Tim Black. Yeah. Everybody like, who the hell is that? He's like, is my mic on?
Yeah. And then he went with Tim Black after I just told him. I said, man, what are you doing? He said, I got to slowly go into it. He didn't want to do Tim Black a little while ago.
You got to present it.
I've been trying to tell him.
You got to present it. You got to present it when the source is near. Like, you got to compliment him on his sweatpants. you gotta show him who's boss. You know?
Yeah. You know how to come up in the company, boy.
So you Tim Black now?
He knows how to do it.
Bullshit.
Okay. Yes. Tim Black, 3 Ks.
I'm so happy for you.
Tim Black. It's better than Black-ass Tim.
I like that.
Hey, you gonna do an interview on ABC. Coming up next, Black-ass Tim.
It'll never happen.
Coming up next, Tim Black.
That's good.
Oh, man, that might change it all right there.
That's going to change your life.
It's going to
change
the game.
It's going to change your life right there.
Yeah. He going to put me in his will, y'all. I feel it.
And then when they introduce you, they show your picture, and everybody else says, damn, Black-ass Tim.
They going to change it over.
The Black Tim Black.
The Black Tim, right. Still gonna be Black.
The Black Tim.
Yeah,
Black.
Let us see it.
To my far left, sitting in for the wounded soldier, Bo P. Ladies and gentlemen, Weightballs.
Yeah, happy to be here. Sorry, I'm in Bo P's seat, but I'm gonna be as.
It's all right,
as
man.
Bo P was.
It's all right. And but you know, I will say when Bo P is sitting there, we can see like some of the seat.
Oh, yeah, no. All this seat is full of ass today. This seat got way more ass in it than it used to.
This seat like, damn.
Let him know, Weightball. Let him know. But we glad to have you, boy.
Let him know, Weightball.
I got Bullhead, our Muslim enthusiast and professional, and I don't even think you're real Muslim. But anyway, you know all the information.
You say Muslim.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bullhead.
Assalamu alaikum. And for the whole Muslim world today, Eid Mubarak.
Today
is equivalent to Christmas for the Muslims.
Okay. Ramadan, right?
Yeah.
I'll come back to that. I'm sorry about Ramadan's that. I'm sorry over. About the little incident okay. in Philadelphia, but I'll get back to you on that.
Okay.
They had a shootout in Philadelphia, disrupted the whole Ramadan.
Yeah.
And it wasn't about Ramadan, supposedly. It was about, they were just fighting with each other, but happened to be Ramadan.
Mm.
Oh, well.
Several people shot.
We got special guests from all the way from Augusta, Georgia, ladies and gentlemen. Cookie Hub.
I ain't got no mic, but I'm back here.
In walks Carla.
Hey, I miss my friend.
What's up, Carla?
Y'all can't hear her. She ain't got no mic, but she said she missed me.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what she said. She didn't say she missed y'all. She said she missed me.
Okay.
Right.
And no
said
sandwiches.
She missed everybody.
No sandwiches again.
Well, good to see y'all. I take it y'all witnessed the eclipse.
No.
Are you one of those people?
Man, whatever, man. It was no different than clouds.
See, I'm going to tell you something, man. Mm-hmm. I really wasn't into watching.
Right.
But I happened to be.
What?
Were you in Texas?
No. I was here.
Oh, I was going to say, you were here in totality.
But when the other people were looking at it, they had the glasses on, and they was like, oh, you ain't going to believe this. And I said, give me them damn glasses.
Mm-hmm.
And I put them glass. It was really something to see.
Yeah.
Really? So I missed out.
You missed out, bro.
It won't happen for another.
It was something to see. In the middle of the day, with your naked eye, you couldn't see nothing. But if right. you put them eclipse glasses mm-hmm. on, nah. you could actually see the moon coming over in front of the sun.
So now, DC, when you say that, there's another group of people that I remember Charles Barkley during halftime, during the national game, said, shout out to all the idiots who just looking up in the sky, watching it get dark. So now, do you feel that you were part of something special, or is this just another?
I'm saying it was something to see. It caught me off guard because I was like, that was
right.
Before I actually saw it, and when I saw it, I mean, you know how I be thinking. All kind of shit started going through my mind. Rev, I started thinking about the crucifixion. When Jesus was crucified and the sun refused to shine, mm-hmm. I'm saying God did it, but he could have done it by way of an eclipse.
Right, because you said
sun
it was
refused
dark
to shine
and,
the crucifixion and
the sun was dark and the veil was broken. And
it could have been.
Yeah.
You know, it was from 3 o'clock in the evening to 6 o'clock. Right. Jesus supposedly died at 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
Right.
And from 3 to 6, sun refused to shine. He could have, I'm not saying God didn't do it, I'm saying God could have caused the eclipse.
Yeah, it just puts you in the mind of
and
that.
And shut the sun down
yeah.
for 3 hours. Yeah. I mean, I thought puts thinking about all kind of shit. Man, when I actually saw it.
Okay.
I mean, I actually, with them glasses.
Saw the moon go in front of the sun. Was
and I took pictures. They say you couldn't take pictures. What I did, I'm telling you, man.
You put the glasses over the.
Boy! Okay. I put the glasses on my phone. And then I took the picture. I show them to y'all on the bridge.
Yeah. Okay. I
put the
check
glass
them out.
On my phone. And it ain't clear as I can see it, but it's.
You got it.
Now,
what does the next one do?
Nah.
54 years?
40 years, something like that. You'll be 90.
I'll make that.
90.
I'll make that. Always winning.
Yes, I'll make that.
Now, what I will say is, I agree with you on all the spirituality, but I disagree on the fact that you couldn't do nothing with your naked eye. Like, literally, I forgot it was an eclipse.
Yeah.
Like, I had been reading about it, I heard about it, but then, you know, I'd be off the grid. So I'm just working from home. But I work from home in front of a big window, so I'm just looking out the window like, this is the weirdest looking sky I ever seen.
It was hazy. It was like,
you're going to see a blue. Difference, but you wasn't going to see the
Well, you say, well, it was sepia.
I was like, it was a blue sky, but it wasn't blue. I was like, it looked like it's about to storm. I'm like,
it was
Lord,
like gray.
What's going on, Lord? So even with me out, without me looking at the moon,
you said, Lord.
I say, Lord, what's going on? I said, Lord, what's going on?
And I know Lord said, who the fuck is this?
He's like, you the only nigga that ain't been looking at the news.
Right. In my neighborhood now, what I did notice when I looked up, it got real dim, it got real cloudy, but all the birds kind of just. Stop chirping. Yeah, they started chilled out. My crackheads on my little street, they all scurried in.
Yeah.
It was a whole little moment for all the animals kind of took a nap for about 30 minutes.
It just got a little bit reddish in Midtown. To me, just like it was
in Midtown.
Reddish.
But Midtown, everybody in Midtown's halfway, so you got half the eclipse.
And then there's a whole rainbow. So
right.
When you block out the sun, it affects the rainbow a little different. Then you say, he saw red. The sun blocked out all the other colors of the rainbow, but only the red.
Did you see the eclipse, since JJ?
I didn't see it through the
glasses.
Mm-mm.
You missed them.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, man. I mean, I had planned to miss it. I'm like, give a damn about no.
But a friend of mine actually, she did the same thing. She showed it on Facebook.
What did he say?
There ain't no UV lashes like you could just. I know they got some eclipse lashes out. They had no.
I need to tell the people, Weightball been drinking.
Got this shine.
is on him, man.
But it was something, man. I didn't realize it was going to be as big of an event as it was for white people. Oh, boy, yeah. The Mexicans was in Mexico, I guess.
Yeah, Mexico, that's where they were at.
Or close by.
I'm saying when the eclipse came by there. Man, it got pitch black.
Well, yeah, there was only a path, so the path was from Mexico through Dallas up towards
the
Maine.
The totality path.
Right.
Yeah.
Now, I'm going to tell you something, man, because y'all know my theory about them going to the moon and stuff.
All right.
I don't believe they went.
Exactly.
I don't believe they went. Ain't no gravity on the moon, but the moon rock sitting there while they ain't floating.
That's
around.
Not.
Ain't no gravity. But anyway, to reiterate my point, I heard them talking about the eclipse and all, about the moon. The moon travels 2,000 miles an hour, I think it is.
Mm-hmm.
You can Google it, I don't know. The Earth travels 67,000 miles an hour. How in the hell you fly a vehicle, take off from a planet that's moving 67,000 miles an hour, and land where you want to on another? I don't know what the moon is. It ain't no star, it ain't no planet. That moving 2,000 miles out.
Rocket science. You got to be a rocket science.
Rocket science. Oh yeah, my daughter's dated a few of those. All of them. I'd be like, bitches, you crazy? That nigga ain't no rocket science.
Right. No. But he be high all the time.
Right. I used to tell him I was a rocket scientist. Oh, rocket scientist line.
You know,
rocket science. That's the oldest shit in the book, boy.
Up until I was working with you guys, I was kind of on the other side saying, like, nah, what is DC talking about? Then when he started pointing out some stuff, I was like, I really switched my opinion by being on this show.
Ladies and gentlemen, a convert.
Look at that. Go and walk.
And what I want to say is that.
Give your life to DC.
They never take pictures of, like, they say they landed, but then how did they get the buggy back here? Like how did they get the buggy? You know, because if you go to the Smithsonian, I think they got the so-called moon buggy.
His best point on this fact is that if we've been to the moon, why ain't we been back?
Right.
That's really the best. I know that.
But there are other things now that you can bring like how did y'all get the buggy back? Or and if you didn't bring it back,
why the rocks
why the flag was going straight and not going up? Why the flag wasn't on?
Why the flag wasn't going up? Yeah, why the flag going sideways?
Exactly. So.
And how you get enough fuel?
Well, that has something to do with the gravitational pull.
The moon is 250,000 miles from here, approximately.
Right.
The sun is almost 100 million miles. The sun is 400 times the distance. However, the sun is also 400 times as large as the moon. The diameter of the moon, if I'm not mistaken, is a couple thousand miles. Diameter of the Earth.
This nigga is a scientist.
The diameter, I be reading. The diameter of the Earth.
Exactly.
The diameter of the Earth is 10,000 miles.
Yes.
But you tell me how you can land a rocket on the moon, even if it's only a fifth of the size of the Earth, and in the background of the supposed landing, you can see the curvature of the planet. If you land anywhere on Earth, ain't no way in hell you can see. You got
That's
to
cause
be.
Earth is flat.
I used to fly.
That's what NASA means, flat Earth.
Uh-huh. You got Kyrie Irving in the building.
Kyrie Irving in the building.
We'll be back. You're listening to DisRace.